Right back in this Football in Focus from the new location. We are Kick Back Jacks on Battleground Avenue. We've got the big Thursday night crowd in the house. Carolina Panthers are on TV later. On Saturday night, you got Conor McGregor versus Floyd Mayweather. Going to be a big battle in the boxing and UFC fighting on Saturday here at Kick Back Jacks. Now Harris with us now. Looking forward to a big battle tomorrow night because Ramsey goes to Asheboro. And you guys are hungry because you lost last week by 1 point. Your senior year, you're hungry. You got to get a win.
Definitely.
What's going to happen to get that big win coming up on Friday night, going down to Asheboro? Got to get that victory.
Really, last week, that Northern Guilford game, it was a tough one that we lost. We just made a few mistakes that we couldn't have. But I feel like this week on the road against Asheboro, we just gotta not make those mistakes. I feel like that at practice, we've been doing much better in terms of execution. And I feel like we won't make those same mistakes this week, and we'll get the win on the road.
I think it's tough to drop that first game of the year, though, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. Just been busting butt, I guess, all week long, trying to get back in order, get things back in shape.
Yeah, definitely. And I feel like this week, the intensity at practice has been much better than we had last week. And I feel like that'll be a deciding factor of the game.
And part of the story is the fact you guys had that 15-3 lead and gave it up. You hate to have a lead like that and let the other team come back and take it, but Northern Guilford was there and they took it.
Yeah, that was a tough one. We just made a couple mistakes that we can't have. And then just this week, we got to bounce back from those mistakes and just be a better team, you know.
Now, your senior year, what are some of the things you're looking to do your senior year? And this is the last roundup. The other guys we talked to Trey Turner so far. Trey is headed to Virginia Tech. Talked down Tisdale, headed to Virginia Tech. I'll be trying to talk to DJ Cross later. He's headed to Virginia Tech. You're one of the players that hasn't committed yet. So how big is this senior year for you as far as your college future? And what are you thinking about as far as that college future goes? Are you starting to think about different schools now?
It's definitely pretty big this year. Right now I have a few offers. And I haven't really decided where I want to go. But I like Army, Air Force, and Richmond, and Western Carolina a lot. I like all those schools a lot. And I believe I'll make my decision pretty soon.
So you probably like it before the season ends?
Yeah, definitely.
Gotcha. Now, you look at the overall for this coming year. You get ready for this big season. First of all, what for you? I know you love it. It's been a part of your life for a long time. What makes football fun for you?
Really, I just like the team aspect of football where you just strap it up and fight right alongside your brother. I like the intensity of the game. Also, it's four quarters. Stop and go, but it's pretty intense.
How about you look at this, some goals you set for this year. I know you got some personal goals you want to do. Some players, you know, kind of stack up things they want to accomplish this year, certain interceptions, certain touchdowns, but just kind of overall some goals you've got for this year.
Well, really, me, I haven't really set many personal goals, but as a team, I really just want to go at least 7 wins and make it to the playoffs.
7-win goal, hit the playoffs. That's a legitimate goal, you would think.
Yeah, definitely.
Because you got to get that win number one this Friday going
right
down to Asheville. What about goals for college football? You get to college. First of all, is get there. You want to get to college, get the school selected, and goals you would have when you go to college.
Really, just contribute to my team however I can, whether it's on the defensive side of the ball or offensive side of the ball, and just do whatever I can to make the team better.
How about goals for life beyond football? After football is over, some of those goals you got?
Really, I like things in the criminal justice field and also a musical field. So anything I can do in those two fields, I'll be satisfied with.
Would you be able to do a little bit of both, you think, or maybe just single out one of those fields and focus on that? Any idea there?
That may be a possibility, but right now I'm just thinking either one or the other.
How about for the football career so far to this date, your biggest play so far during your football career, what's the biggest play been?
Really, I can't even...
You had some big plays that one game last year. Might have been Southern Guilford game, another game. We had like 2 touchdowns the same game, had those returns. Is there a biggest play among any of those?
No, not really. Just I like whenever I score, whenever I can get the ball in the box, that's pretty big to the team. I like when I returned the kick from Ragsdale last year to open up the second half. That was pretty big. And the Page game where I had caught a 80-yard touchdown.
80-yard touchdown, that's one for the books. That's a good one. I guess the biggest play for you might still be out there somewhere.
Yeah, definitely.
How about you think about If you could choose your college roommate among these three people, you choose between Tom Brady, Odell Beckham Jr., or Cam Newton, who would you choose as a college roommate?
I'll probably choose Odell Beckham Jr.
A lot of people have been choosing tonight. I think they like him. Yeah, yeah.
Just simply because we play similar positions, so I feel like I'll be able to relate to him more.
Say you're stuck on a deserted island somewhere by yourself, and you could choose one worldly teammate to be on that deserted island with you to help you out. Who do you choose?
I'll bring all the guys, you know. I can't just choose one. We're a pretty strong team.
Who you're a team man?
Yeah.
Does that go to the senior class, junior class, all players? You just kind of stick like that?
Yeah, definitely.
Gotcha. Most money you've ever spent at a fast food restaurant at one time, buying a bunch of food. Got so hungry you had to buy like a horse. You felt like eating that much. Most money you've ever spent at one stop.
I'll probably say the most money at a fast food restaurant was probably $15, $20.
You got your money's worth for that?
Yeah, definitely.
Which coach in your team could probably still play in the game if he had to? You got any coach in your team that still plays in the game? He could still step up and play?
I think Coach Brown, he's a pretty good all-around athlete. I feel like he could make a good quarterback, you know. And he's pretty smart. Also, my receiver coach, Coach Tripp, and Coach Rigsby, my DB's coach, I feel like they could get some points.
You still got game, right?
I believe so.
If you like somebody to eat dinner with you sometime, a formal dinner, a sit-down dinner, like somebody currently alive now or somebody from the past or present, to sit down one-on-one, a big, special, official-type meal, somebody's got a lot of thought, a lot of process involved, who'd you invite to eat with you at the special meal?
That's a tough question. Let's see. Let me think. I like JFK a lot.
Okay, yeah. Good. That's a good choice. Very good choice. Bring Mr. Kennedy in, see what he did. And man, it'd be the best thing if he came in and just broke everything down and spilled it all out. It'd be a lot of information at that meal that night.
Yeah.
Just talking about his family and your family, both you guys have a lot of share there.
Right.
Nicest person on your team. Who's the nicest person on that Grizzly team?
Nicest person. If I had to choose, I would say Boren Lassane, our running back. I like his work ethic and the way he touches each and every one of us as a teammate.
So he respects you guys and appreciates you guys.
Definitely.
Boren Lassane, let's give him – what year is he?
He's a junior.
Good. Got to come 2 more years this year, next year. Come by. Good. What about meanest person on your team? Who's the mean one over there?
Meanest, I couldn't even tell you because we're all pretty nice guys.
I've seen Lance McMillan sometimes get a little ferocious on some of those hits he puts on during some of those scrimmages. I saw that earlier this year. Lance comes pretty hard. Is he not the man?
Yeah, sometimes.
Could possibly be. Last sprints of the day. You guys do those last sprints, and you're going to just chugging hard. Coach Brown's got you guys broken up and running your tails off. Last sprints of the day, who finishes first? That last sprint, who gets that finish in the first place?
Usually it's between us DBs, where there's me, or Justin Santiago, who's our safety bandit player, or Bourne, our running back, he finishes pretty up top up there. So between us, I'll say like most of the DBs, we always finish first.
How do you run them? Do you guys run as DBs, linebackers together, linemen? How do you guys run?
Sometimes he'll split us up into defense and offense, mm-hmm. and then all the offensive player goes first, and all the defensive players go after that. Or sometimes, like yesterday, when we finished practice, we all went at the same time, offense and defense. So, usually we just go defense after offense goes.
When those linemen are, who's the top lineman running out there for you?
Top lineman, never really paid attention to it, but I'll probably say Antonio Boyd. He's one of our defensive linemen, defensive end player.
How about someone on your team, this might be you, that could start in a national music video, that could be a star in one of those? Who would that be?
National music video.
That might be you, might be someone else.
One of our DBs, you might not know him, but Najir Blair, he's one of our DBs, and whenever we go on the road, whenever we win, on the way back, he's always doing sort of a freestyle rap type thing, so... I think I would say him.
Give him a shout out again.
Nigel Blair, number 29 for us.
Nigel Blair Grimms in the music video. 10 years from now, we look 10 years ahead, looking down the road, where will you be and what will you be doing 10 years from now? Where are you going to be living and what are you going to be doing?
Right now, I'm not sure. Just whatever my career may be, wherever life may carry me, I'll be fine with.
You're not exactly sure yet,
though? I'm not sure yet.
What will you be doing tomorrow?
Tomorrow, I'll be preparing for the game.
There you go. You're that close, Lennon. You're one day at a time, one day at a time. No doubt about it. You hit it big. You strike it rich. You make it to the NFL. Got some good money coming in. What do you buy your mom?
Well, I'll buy my mom. I'll probably buy her a new car, maybe or a new house, maybe something like that.
Something nice for mom. How about this? The perfect play on Friday night. What's the perfect play for you?
Perfect play. I wouldn't really say there's a perfect play, but offensively, I feel like putting together a good drive. I'll take a lot of time off the clock and take a lot of energy out of the defense. I feel that would be like maybe a perfect series, you know, type thing. And also on defense, getting as many three and outs as we can, or even better, getting a turnover, whether it's an interception or a fumble.
How about this? How much offense do you play now? How much defense? Is it mainly just defense now, or are you doing some offense too?
No, I play equal amounts of time on offense and defense. I start on both sides of the ball.
How about this? Last question. Tell us who you play tomorrow night, and tell us why you will be the winner. Because we all know who you're playing. We've heard about it already. But tell us again who you play tomorrow night and why your team will be the winner tomorrow night.
So tomorrow we play Asheboro High School in Asheboro. And I feel that we will win tomorrow night because we are better mentally prepared and physically prepared in terms of our practice ethic. We picked it up a lot this week. And our game plan going into that game, I feel like is a pretty good game plan. And defensively, we're expecting to shut them out.
And is it a big challenge? This Asheboro team is a big challenge for you guys, right?
I believe it'll be a challenge because their first week game against Randleman, they put up about 35 points. But defensively, I feel like that we can hold them to 0 points.
What do you got to do to get into the game? How you got to start out? Got to start out on fire? Got to start out slow and steady? How you got to start out?
We got to start out on fire, on top, just, you know, making big plays from the beginning to the end of the game.
Now, always good to see you, my friend.
You too.
Did a great job as always. You'll get your meal here today at the Outback Jacks on Battleground. Good Football in Focus show. Now, Harris, if we had, you could give out a graduation certificate. This guy's been with us almost every year since back when he was like in ninth grade. If we could give him a graduation certificate, we would, because he's come a long way and done a very good job. Always sharp, always steady, and always composed and on top of the game.
Definitely.
Thank you much.
Thank you, man.
Good to see you as always.